Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Pricie here, back with some more World of Tanks footage for you today. This was a game that I played last night. I'm playing with D for Derp. As you can see, I'm in the T29 Tier 7 American Heavy Tank. D4 is in his, I feel really sorry for him, but the poor bastard's in a Tiger P Tier 7 German heavy-ish tank. Tiger P, you can call it a Tiger P because it's either a Tiger prototype or a Tiger Porsche, depending on which one you want to look at. And we are here on Winter Himmelsdorf. If you can notice from the side there, looking at the team lists, we are the bottom feeders in this team. We are bottom of the pile, bottom of the heap. Nobody loves us. We're tier 7s in a tier 9 game. It's going to be an interesting one. But let's see what we can do. The T29 is generally regarded to be probably the best tier 7 heavy tank. And when you can get it into a hold down situation, you can make up for the fact that it's not a tier 8 or tier 9. So let's see how things go. As you can see, our team's spreading out. Not a bad spread. There's not really enough people at the banana. There's two fail platoons in this team as well. We've got an M6 on our team because reasons. But the enemy team have got an issue 100 as well, because obviously the raisins are strong with them as well, so no problem. And we're moving up towards the Chateau de Himmelsdorf, on top of the hill, to see if we can put some fire in, get that tank on a hold down location at the top of this road here and try and do some work. Now, I do admit this replay was played at about 1:30 in the morning. B, I was quite drunk. And C, there's two enemy artillery pieces on the enemy team that both out-level my tank. So this is why I'm moving so erratically up and down the hill like this, zigzagging all around the place after I fired, weaving around, backing far too far down the hill. Those three contributing reasons is basically, normally the only places on Himmelsdorf where artillery can really be effective is up the 1 or 2 line, or where I am now, this exact position where I am now, on the top of the up ramp on the hill for the enemy team's side. So, every time I fire and I get spotted, I am backing away like an absolute madman because I don't want to get clicked on. But so far, we're on 985 damage. I've put some really good hits into some higher tier tanks. In fact, the one good thing about being a tier 7 tank in a tier 9 game is just about everything you shoot at is higher tier than you, so great success. Now on 1304 damage. Put some hits into a T-54 lightweight, who's a good player from Odium. T-34, who's their best player. A T-34-2 and an IS-6. So I blow the tracks off this WZ-120 Tier 9 Medium, call for fire support on him, get some good assistance damage, fire another shot straight through the front, set him on fire and finish him off with a nice engine fire, so great success. The IS-6 goes down, so I'm on 1758 damage. It's still a bit touch and go as to whether or not the hill is actually ours, but me and the T-34 have been doing quite good work, we move in. Oh, there's my friendly neighbourhood artillery. As I say, they tend to be focused on this part of the map. They know the heavies are going to be here, so thank you very much for clicking me and taking away a quarter of my health, although I should be lucky. That was a miss. So, artillery, fair and balanced. So, now, the IS-3 comes YOLOing in. Bit of a poor shot that I take here. I'm trying to take his tracks off, but just a little bit too late on the shot, and it ricochets off the front of his tank. But then I come around behind him as he's totally tunnel visioned on our T-34 and put one through the rear of his tank. He takes careful aim, finishes off our T-34 sadly, but right, that gives me the opportunity to finish him off in the rear. So, alright, fair's fair. I think I'm now the only person left on the hill. So I suppose you could say the hill is won. It's 10-10. The team results are still quite tight. I take a little punt at this 704 down now, but I don't think it connected. He's got the same amount of health, or if it did, it bounced off of his Stalinium gun mantlet, hit the moustache and didn't do any damage. So now I'm just going to have a little lurk by the side of this wall here, because I know that he would have spotted me or re-spotted me once I shot at him. So I'm going to wait for the spot to wear off before I try to make any next dramatic movements. Don't want to get clicked by the artillery. The T-34 wants me to move, apparently, and wants me to go down and help the artillery against the ISA, but that's not the right play to make here, so I say negative, I'm going to do something else. The right play to make here is to go after their artillery, take those guys out of the game, and then try to put some cap pressure on if I can. The T-49's already there, and he's looping around in the cap circle, and I'm not sure what he's doing. He really should be going for the artillery. He's got the speed, he's got the manoeuvrability, but if for some reason he's heading up to the hill to come and help me, then there's nobody here for him to help me against, so fair enough, no problem. He's not the strongest of players, but we can point him in the right direction in a minute. So I'm heading down the hill, slowly trundling towards the cap. I ping the T-49 and tell him to look over at the K2 location and tell him to go find the arty. If we can get those guys out of the game, that's a real big advantage, and it only really then leaves Object 704 to deal with. So, coming down, just get down off the hill. Our T-30 is still in the game, so we can see how he does in a minute against the Object 704. He finds the 704, but the 704 ends him, unfortunately. So now it's me and a T-49 versus an Object 704 and two artillery pieces. Just went for a quick pause there because I've noticed the replays tend to lag a little bit. As we mentioned before in previous replays, when we was, if you watched the WZ120 replay from Tumas, the last one that I put up, tended to lag just a little bit in certain areas. Just a problem with the World of Tanks replay system. Nothing really I can do about that, but a quick pause puts it back to fluidity again so we can carry on. So the T-49 gets derped in the face by their M40, M43, because fair and balanced, yes, artillery, no problem. Now I've loaded HE here, and you might think that's a bit of a silly idea considering I just did 78 damage to the artillery piece, but bearing in mind I can't see a lot of him now, and the only thing I can see is his tracks, and if I'd fired AP, there was a good chance that I wouldn't have done any damage at all and just hit him in the tracks. Now that artillery piece has got 400 health, and after those two HE shots, I've brought him down to be a one shot, which is actually a critical part of me carrying this game basically. He's now on 278 health. Their Object 704's come back to the cap to defend, but I angle my armour against him just at the right time, and he donks the shot into my tracks, although that one really hurt. So I reload APCR because the side armour on a 704 can be quite troll when you're shooting at it through angles. It can get up to 200mm of side armour in certain angles, so I want to make sure that the shots go in and, if possible, do damage. I get so lucky here, it is unbelievable. I blow his tracks off, but he shoots me in the side, but fortunately donks it into my track. He could have quite easily have killed me there. And then, oh, surprise artillery, he comes around, so he gets a shot. And the Object 704's got his tracks back up again. So after tracking him twice, making him burn a repair kit, tracking him again, I've got to track him a third time. But I put the shot in through his front drive wheel, blow his tanks off, and now it's GG, really. FV207 agrees. He says, nice. Well played to you, sir. And now this guy is just at my mercy. There's nothing he can do. My reload's faster than his repair skill. I can just keep putting shot after shot through his tracks, keeping him pinned in place. He's just a captive audience for me. So I can just feast on him. And GG. Last shot goes in. That's the end of the game. So let's have a look at the end game stats for that. So here we are at the end game score screen for that round on Winter Himmelsdorf in the T29 Tier 7 American Heavy Tank. As you can see, that was a casual mastery badge for me there, no problem. If you're going to do a good round in a two-tiered under tank in a tier 9 game, then you're probably going to get a mastery badge, so there you go, no problem. That was also my daily double for the T29, so with premium I came away with 6,254 experience for that, which is very nice indeed. Got a few of these other crazy new tokens that they've brought in, but who really cares about them? So let's have a look at the team score page. As you can see, that was a whopping 1668 base experience there. And the reason I got such a high base experience was purely because of the fact that I was, for the most part, always shooting tanks that were a higher tier than me. So, great success. did 3,917 damage, got top damage on my team, as well as 4 kills, which led me to the 1,668 base. Although hats off to the Object 704 on the enemy team, he did 4,500 damage on a map that's not really the best suited for a tank destroyer. And he still got himself a courageous resistance for high caliber, 4 kills, and 1,059 base experience. So well played to you, sir. You had a good game. And the fight at the end certainly was nail-biting, as far as I'm concerned. If we go over to the detailed report, you can see that I fired 22. Out of the 22 I fired, I hit 19. And out of the 19 I hit, I penned 17, which is really good for a tier 7 tank in a tier 9 game. Goes to show you that I had a little bit of the RNG luck on my side that game. And perhaps maybe I'm a little bit too OP when I'm drunk and I need to be nerfed. But we'll see. So that was 3.9k damage. I received 4 hits, of which 3 penetrated, 1 didn't penetrate. And a bit of splash damage, and the damage blocked by armor was 1,000 damage. So thank God it didn't penetrate, or otherwise that would have been the end of my game. And that was probably the couple of tracking shots that I received as well. So no problem. I did 1,092 assistance damage, but that doesn't really matter. I did have to fire a bit of APCR at the end of the game there, just to make sure that I did damage and also made sure I blew the tracks off the Object 704. I couldn't have fooled a mistake there, so I was spamming the gold a little bit towards the end of the game. But even with that, I still made 10,000 credits in profit, even after all of the deductions. So I can't really argue with that. Now, of course, if you enjoyed this replay, then you can give me a thumbs up. That always helps me out massively. If you're not a subscriber to the channel, then you can hit the subscribe button and then you're free and eligible to submit replays for my subscriber replay section. Of course, you guys have been absolutely fantastic and awesome, as always, for watching the replay. I love you so much. I've been Pricie. You guys have been awesome. And I'll see you on the next one.